Hello everyone. In this video lecture, let us continue understanding module 2 basic concepts. In this lecture, let us understand the remaining data types, arrays, memories, parameters, and strings. First, let us understand about the arrays. So we all know that arrays represents a collection of elements of similar data type. So in Verilog, we can declare arrays for register data type, integer data type, time, and real data type. So we can declare any number of dimensions, a multidimensional array can be declared. And in Verilog, arrays are declared using square brackets, so which is similar to the vector declaration. But the difference is this square bracket must appear after the name of the variable. Vectors, the square bracket appears before the name of the variable, but for arrays, the square bracket appears after the name of the variable. Let us look into examples. So here we are declaring an array whose name is count. So we can observe here we have the square bracket which represents the array. This square bracket is written after the name of the variable. And the number of elements in the array is specified by this dimensioning, where we mention the 0th element first and the 7th element. So this goes in the order of the index numbers, where the first number will be a smaller number and the last number will be larger. Unlike in vectors where we declare the MSB first and the LSB next, here we declare the index variable, the lower index is represented first and the last index. So from 0 to 7 we have totally 8 numbers. So this declares an array named count. That array has 8 elements and each element of this array count is of type integer. That is, it can hold positive numbers, negative numbers, integer numbers. So this is an array count of 8 count variables. Second example. So this declares an array named sum. This array has how many elements? 0 is to 31, meaning to say 32 elements are there, and each of these elements is of type REG. And what are the values REG can take? REG can take either 0, 1, X or Z. So all the values within this array named sum is just 1 bit value. So this is declaring an array of 32 1 bit sum register variables. Next, so time checkpoint 1 is to 100. So checkpoint, this is declaring an array whose name is checkpoint. The number of elements here, if you carefully observe, the index numbering starts from a 1, unlike the previous example where it starts from a 0. So when it starts from 1, the ending number is the actual count of the array. So 1 to 100, we all know that there are 100 elements. So checkpoint is an array having 100 elements and each element in the array is of type time. That is, it will store the simulation time values. So we are declaring an array of 100 time checkpoint variables. Now, register port ID. Port ID is the name of the array. If you observe, we have put a square bracket both on the left hand side and the right hand side. So what does this indicate, whether port ID is an array or a vector? Simple. So port ID is declared as an array because the square bracket is appearing after the name of this variable. 0 to 7 indicates this port ID has 8 elements in that array, and this numbering over here tells you that each element in the array is of type register, which is a 5-bit number. This is a vector, so 4 to 0 means totally 5 bits. So it's declaring an array of 8 port IDs, each is 5-bit wide. So from this, what do we consider, conclude? Vector is a single element. So vector is just one number which is multiple bit wide. For example, 1010. This is one number which is 4-bit wide. But array is a multiple elements that are n bit wide. So we can have an array of 4. For example, in this case, we can have 5 bit numbers, say 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. That's one number. Like that, we can have 8 numbers in that particular array. So vector is a single element, whereas array is multiple elements which are n bit wide. Now let us understand how to access elements of an array. Just like how we accessed elements of a vector by mentioning a square bracket after the name of the variable and mentioning the bit number we were interested to access, similarly, for accessing an element of the array, we are going to mention the element number inside a square bracket which is written after the variable name. So when we say count of 5 is equal to 0, in the previous slide we had declared count as an integer array. So this is going to set the fifth element in the array as 0. So when you write this statement, it is going to make 0 or reset the fifth element of the array of count variables. Checkpoint of 100 equal to 0. In the previous slide, we saw that checkpoint was declared of type time. The 100th element of that array is made as 0. That is, we are resetting the 100th time checkpoint. Port ID of 3 equal to 0. So, port ID we had declared as an array of type register. So, the third element in that array, we are resetting or making it equal to 0, which is a 5-bit number. So, it is going to be initialized to 5 zeros. Now, port ID we had declared it as an array. So, we cannot just randomly initialize an array equal to 0. That is an illegal syntax. Let us see some more examples of an array. So, integer matrix 4 is to 0, 0 is to 255. So, this is declaring a two-dimensional array, which is a 5 cross 256. 4 is to 0 means it is 5. 0 is to 255 means it is totally 256. So, it's declaring a two-dimensional array of integers. So, every element in the two-dimensional array is an integer. So, array 4D. So, this is representing, if we see, we have 4 different SPICE specifications. So, this is a 4-dimensional array and each element of the array is of type register, which is 64-bit wide. Let us see how the arrays can be visualized as. So, 1-dimensional array is nothing but it's a single row of elements. You can visualize that as a line. 2-dimensional array is a row and a column of elements. So, you can visualize that as a square. 3-dimensional array is a row, column and page of elements. So, it is like a cube. And 4-dimensional is a row, column and a row of page of elements. So, it is like a row of cubes. So, that's an imaginations of those arrays. We can declare wire data type also as array. So, wArray declares an array having 6 elements. 5 is to 0, 6 elements. And each element in the array is of 8-bit wide. Wire data type or the net data type. So, it's declaring an array of 6 elements. This is the number of elements in the array and this is the size of each element. Each element is 8-bit wide. So, this is declaring a 2-dimensional array. So, it's an array of single bit wires. So, this is declaring a 2-dimensional array having 8 rows and 6 columns and each element is just 1-bit wide. Let us understand the next data type, that is the memories. So, we all know that RAM and ROM, they are modeled in Verilog as one-dimensional array of registers. So, memories are nothing but one-dimensional array of registers. We know register data type, we know how to declare an array of registers which are one-dimensional. One-dimensional means only one set of numbers mentioned. So, one-dimensional array of register is a memory. Each element of the array, we call that as an element, and to access each element, we need an index variable which identifies the element number. And each element or each word can be either 1-bit or it can be more than 1-bit. Example. So, we said memory represents a one-dimensional array of registers. Observe, register is mentioned. The name of this memory is mem-bit. We have put a square bracket after the name of this variable. So, this is an array. 0 is to 1023 means totally it is 1024 and there is no number or no square bracket before this variable. So, each variable is 1-bit wide. So, this is declaring a memory, a one-dimensional array of registers or a memory having 1024 elements and each element is 1-bit wide. It's declaring a memory mem-bit with 1k locations. 1024 is 1 kilobyte locations. Each location can store only 1-bit of information. Now, what if you want each location to store 8-bit of information? So, I'm just giving another name, mem-byte. Mem-bit, it's a memory which can store only 1-bit of information. Mem-byte is the name I'm giving assuming that it can store 8 bits of information. Observe, remember, all memories must and should be declared of type register. Whenever we are declaring memory, it is one dimensional array of registers. So you should write register, the name of the memory, the number of elements 1024, and each, here you have a square bracket before this, so this is a vector. This means each location can store 8 bits of information. So this is a memory mem-byte with 1k locations and each is 8 bit wide. So if you want to access any element or any particular location in the memory, same like accessing vector, same like accessing an array, we just have to put a square bracket and tell the location or the address of which memory location you are interested to store some data or retrieve some data. For example, mem-byte of 511 means memory location whose address is 511, that data is fetched. So it will fetch 1 byte of word from the address 511. A pictorial representation of the same thing. So when we declare register mem 1 bit 0 is to 1023, it creates an array having 0 to 1023 means totally 1024 locations or 1 kilobyte locations, but each location just can store 1 bit of information. Either a single 1 or a single 0 can be stored because there is no size mentioned here. In the second example where you have written 7 down to 0, this means this memory location has the same number of locations, that is 0 to 1023, it has 1024 memory locations. Each memory location can store now 7 down to 0, that is 8 bit of information, combinations like 101010. So totally 8 digits have to come in over here, 8 bits have to come here. And if you write here mem byte of 511, you can fetch that particular memory location. Let's say somewhere here we have 511 as the address. So that location can be fetched by writing a square bracket after the name of the array. So this is a pictorial representation of how a memory declaration and access looks like. The next data type that we're going to study is the parameter data type. So Verilog allows constants to be defined in a module using the keyword parameter. So parameters are basically constants whose values cannot be used as variables. But though they are constants, the parameter values, they can be changed at the module instantiation using the def parent statement. So though parameter defines a constant, that value can be changed using the def parent statement, which we will be understanding in the further modules. Example, parameter port ID is equal to 5. So this declares a constant named port ID whose value is 5. So anywhere in the program port ID is used, it is substituted with value 5. Parameter mem is equal to 256. This declares a constant named mem whose value is 256. Parameter signed 15 down to 0 width. So if we observe here, width is the name of the constant we are declaring. Parameter signed, so we are fixing this particular width as a signed data type, and wherever the variable width is used, its size is 16 bit vector. So 15 down to 0 means it is a 16 bit vector. So we can fix even the sign and the range for the parameter width. Verilog allows parameter whose values cannot be changed using the local parameters. So local param is the keyword to be used. So if you declare a constant using the local parameter, then you cannot change the value using any statement unlike the parameter. The statements, that is the values, cannot be altered using the def param statements. Example, state encoding of machines, they are constant values and you do not want to change that. So we can use the local parameter definition in such cases. Example, state 1 is equal to, we are assigning a 4 bit value to state 1, state 2, state 3, state 4. We don't want these values to be changed, so we can use the local parameter declaration whose values cannot be changed. The next data type that we are going to study now is the string data type. So we all know that strings represent a group of characters stored within double quotes. So strings in Verilog can be stored in the register data type. The width of the register variable in which we are storing that string should be equal to, or it should be larger than, the size of the string. So each character in the string takes up 8 bits or 1 byte. We all know that every character on the keyboard, that is alphabetic, numerical, special characters, each character has a 8 bit distinct ASCII value. Every character has a different ASCII value which is of 8 bit, right? So every character will take up 8 bit size. If the width of the register is greater than the size of the string, then Verilog will fill zeros to the left. For instance, let us assume we have declared a register who can store 8 bytes, because each character can store 1 byte. We need 8 bytes to be stored. Let's say we want to store hello. Hello has H-E-L-L-O, 5 characters. So out of the 8 bytes available, only 5 bytes are filled. The leftmost bytes which are empty are filled with zeros. In case the width of the register is smaller than the size of the string, then Verilog will truncate the leftmost bits. For instance, if we have a 3-byte wide register, and if you are interested to store hello, hello has 5 characters, but the option available is only 3 space. So the MSB, the most leftmost bits, H and E, are truncated from the string. So it is very important that we match the size of the string and the register which is going to hold the string, so that no data is lost. So now let us see how strings are declared in Verilog. So strings can be stored in register. So strings are declared using the keyword register, reg, followed by the name of the strings. Here the name is string value. It is represented like a vector on the left hand side, but the change here is, so 19 is to 1 means totally 19 characters are there, because if this was a 0, then 19 is to 0 is 20 characters. 1 to 19, there are only 19 numbers. So 19 is to 1 means it is 19 locations are there. This into 8, 8 into 19 means each location is 8 byte wide. So this is declaring a variable named string value that is 19 byte wide. Into 8 makes each location a byte width rather than a bit width. And all the string variables, because we have declared it as register, we know the rule for assigning any value to a register. It must be done inside the initial statement. For instance, string value is equal to hello Verilog world. Let us count the number of characters in this. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have a space. The blank space has to be counted in strings. So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Blank space 14. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So totally there are 19 characters. Each character is 8 bit, because we know every character has an ASCII value. For example, A has ASCII value 41, capital A, B has 42, and so on. So that ASCII value is 8 bit wide. So there are 19 locations. Each location is 8 bit wide. It can store 8 bytes over there. So strings can be stored in a... Strings also serve a special purpose in displaying newline characters, tabs. Special characters can be displayed in strings when they are preceded by the escape character, the backslash. So this table gives us a reference of how the different string formats, the escaped characters, can be displayed. For instance, the backslash n, the character which is displayed is a new line. That is, a new line is generated. Backslash t, that means a tab is generated, a tab space is generated. 2% symbol means a single percentage symbol is displayed. 2 backslash symbol means the backslash. So the character after the backslash is single backslash, so that is displayed. So backslash double quotes, the character after the backslash is double quotes, that is displayed. And if we use backslash OOO, 3 O's, the character will be written in 3 octal digits, 1 to 3 octal digits. What does this mean? Let's take an example. So we just understood that the ASCII value of capital A is 41. So the 8-bit representation of the ASCII value is 01004 and 0001, which is 1. Similarly, the ASCII value of small case a is 61. So the 8-bit representation of this ASCII value is 01106 and 0011. So now if we use slash backslash 000, then this 8-bit number gets split up into 3 octal digits individually. So here we can see the split up of 3 octal digits. So finally, in octal number system, this looks like 101, this looks like 141. Let's look into an example. So we have declared a module named test string. We are declaring a string which can store 19 characters. Each character is 8 byte wide. So we are telling what is the string, that is hello very long world, which has totally 19 characters including the blank space also. And we are telling after 10 time units, hash 10, dollar display, so we are telling to display, percentage s means it displays the string directly. Who is having the string? The variable string value, so that argument is included over here. Now let us see the different representation. So in this example, the size of the string we are storing in the string variable is matches exactly. So we have declared a 19 byte string. So we have 19 characters, which is perfectly sorting. It works perfectly fine. In case we have given a larger size, let's say we have declared a string with 23 bytes, then the leftmost bits are filled with zeros. But we don't have any problem because all the characters are still there. So a larger string size or the same string size is of no harm. But if we use a variable which has a smaller string size, let's say we have declared a 17 byte string, but here we have totally 19 characters, then we can observe we are losing out the leftmost bits. H and E are lost, they are truncated. So we should be very careful when we declare strings. It is good practice to have a larger size to be on a safer side. Let us take up some exercise problems to understand the declarations better. So the first one tells us to declare an 8-bit vector net called AIN. So when you see the word net, you have to understand the keyword is wire AIN. It's a vector, so we have to use wire 7:0 AIN. I hope you got it. So 8-bit vector wire net is a wire, name given here is AIN. They're asking you to declare a vector, so the square bracket is on the left hand side. 8-bit means 7:0. A 32-bit storage register called address. Bit 31 must be the most significant bit. Set the value of the register to a 32-bit decimal number equal to 3. So first point, let us declare this particular storage register. Storage register means it is REG. What is the name of that? It is address. So it is REG address. They are asking it the size to be 32-bit. So it's a vector representation. So it will be REG address. 32 means 31:0. So they are telling the bit 31 must be the MSB. Yes, it is MSB. And then they are telling set the value of the register to a 32-bit decimal number 3. So we know registers must be initialized inside the keyword initial. So they are telling set the value. Set the value means address is equal to 32-bit decimal. So 32 tick D, the number given is 3. Next, this is a simple declaration. Declare an integer called count. So it is simple. Integer, name of the integer is count. Declare a time variable called snapshot. So this is also straightforward. Write the keyword time followed by the name snapshot. An array called delays, and the array contains 20 elements of type integer. So we know that arrays are represented using square brackets. Each element in the array is integer. So we start the declaration as integer. The name of the array is delays and the array contains 20 elements. So the square bracket has to come after the name of the variable. 0:19, 20 elements. A memory mem containing 256 words of 64 bit each. So we know that memory is a one-dimensional array of registers. Register data type is declared using the keyword REG. The name of the memory is MEM. It's one dimensional array of registers. So the number of elements in the array is 256. So the square bracket comes after the mem variable. So 0:255 is totally 256. But if we do not write this, each element is 1 bit. But they have specified it is each element is 64 bit. So the vector declaration happens on the left hand side. Each element size is 64 bit. A parameter cache size equal to 512. This is a straightforward declaration. Parameter cache size is equal to 512. So in this video lecture, we understood the data types, arrays, memories, parameters, and strings with an example. Thank you.